Good day, fellow investors. The last time I did an overview video about my channel was when we had about 20,000 something subscribers. Now we have passed 35,000 and I thank you all. And the time has come to really systematize everything that I do on this channel to help the new subscribers and the future ones. So what you can expect in this video are my goals. How do I invest? What is the main message that I'm trying to send over? You can hear more about who am I, my background, my past, and what has led me to being now an investment manager, a researcher. Then we will discuss whether this channel is actually for you, what you can expect on this channel, what is the value that I try to transmit. And then I'll give you also more resources from the book where you can learn more about how and what I do. So let's immediately start with what is my main investing message, my main investing goal. And it's very simple. My goal is to achieve sustaining high investment returns with minimized risk. So this is the basis of value investing. A value investor first looks at the downside to limit permanent capital loss in a way or another, be it a diversification, be it with a margin of safety, book value, and then he leaves the upside to what might happen over the long term. For example, if I buy a business that has tangible book value of $1 and I pay $1 and that business is currently in a cyclical downturn, which means, okay, this is the worst that can happen because the world will go on. And then in 5 years, everything is good, everybody's excited about that business and the stock price is at three. I have invested at a point in time where, yes, the stock price can go lower, but the permanent capital loss is limited. And I leave the upside to whatever can happen in the business, in the environment, etc. Further, what I look for is, for example, a company can decide to build a new plant, a new mine, whatever, and they have high expected investments at the beginning for, let's say, 3 years, and analysts, as Wall Street works now, are focused on the short term. They will be focused on the costs, on the investments, on the debt, on the risk, and very few will focus on the long term, on the increased earnings, let's say in 2022. And this is an advantage that we small investors have over Wall Street. Wall Street is focused quarter by quarter, maximally what will happen next year. And very few look at what will happen over the next 3, 5, 10 years. And that's an advantage that I like to look at businesses, see how they fit that long-term growth chart and then position myself when there is a high, let's say, relatively safe return on investment. Usually I target at 15% over the long term. This doesn't mean it will be linear. It can be 3 years of nothing and then when the earnings kick in, a jump. But that's hard to time, so that's more about portfolio positioning. So to summarize the investment style, I look for double-digit returns with a margin of safety, let's say value investing. I'm looking to buy businesses that will be there over the next 5, 10, 20 years, no matter what happens. And then I try to buy them when those are relatively cheap towards their intrinsic value. The market goes up and down constantly, so there are plenty of opportunities to buy such stocks if you are patient. When I say plenty, I'm very happy with 5 to 10 stocks per year that I buy and three really good ones where I put big part of my portfolio. So that's what I'm targeting. That is my investment style. And I get to those stocks by simply doing as much research as I can. I spend my days looking at stocks, looking at research, building reports, comparing investments, risk and reward. That's what I do. And that's what I translate to this YouTube channel. Another example, we see it happening all around us. The world is going electric, the world is going renewable, etc. Even my mother has installed solar panels on her roof last year. So these trends are there. There is more and more of it. We know that the cost of solar is getting lower and lower, but when you are investing, these trends are never linear. Some years there is more, some years there is less. And that has big repercussions on stock prices of such stocks. So you have to understand, okay, when you analyze the whole sector stock by stock and then you find those that will do good, no matter what happens in the sector. Forget about linearity, and then you buy low and you see whether you sell high or you just keep because it is a good business. In that line of renewables, I expect that the world will be using more copper, because you need more copper in electrical vehicles, for example, in solar panels, more zinc, more other related metals over the next decade. And that's a trend I am investing in. But when it comes to investing in such a trend, it's not you just buy an ETF or buy stocks. All those that have been investing in the 1990s, we all knew that, okay, the internet is going to do well, the internet is going to change the world. 99% of people lost money actually by investing in internet stocks in the 2000 dot-com bubble because they didn't think about risk, they were overexcited, exuberance. And what I tried to do also on this channel is warn people about the risks of investing, as I did over the Bitcoin last year and things like that, and focus on margin of safety, value investing to avoid such losses. If you can avoid such losses, you do a great deal for your portfolio and your long-term investment returns. So to summarize, I focus on margin of safety, risk in a way that no matter what happens, I don't lose money, and I leave the upside to the cycle, to the market's exuberance, to the market's volatility. And I buy when I'm happy with the business return, with the average business return over the cycle. You know, pessimism and positivism, exuberance change places very quickly in the market. And that's something we really have to take advantage, because that's really a gift you cannot leave there. If you look at margin of safety, you can take advantage of that. Who is Sven Carlin? Well, first and foremost, I'm now a 100% full-time independent stock market researcher. So 90% of my time is spent looking at stocks, looking at stock lists, understanding trends, looking at intrinsic values of stocks, the margin of safety, the risk and reward, putting that all into my Excel sheet where I compare which is the best investment for my portfolio now. And I'm looking for those stocks that have positive long-term trends and are cheap in relation to those trends, as we have already mentioned. Before devoting myself to full-time investing, I was always partly related to investments, and I was also, for 3 years, I was a professor of finance and accounting at the University of Applied Sciences of Amsterdam, where I tuned my accounting and business skills that really helped me now when it comes to investing. Before that, I had a short period that I worked for Bloomberg in London as a data researcher, so I understand how to get to the data, what to look for, what do analysts look for, what they don't look for, and what do I have to look for to reach those low risk, high return investments, or to patiently wait for the analysts to panic. The key with analysts is that they focus on the short term, while long-term investors have an advantage, because if you look at what will happen over 3 years, you have an advantage over the analyst that looks at what will happen over the next quarter. Before working at Bloomberg, I was a teacher, so that's why I like this YouTube, because I like helping people, I like educating people. And while being a teacher, I did a Ph.D. where I analyzed an emerging market, and I did a risk reward model for stocks that explained pretty well what happens in the stock market, better than other academic models, because it was a value investing model focused on risk. And then again, it focuses on book value, changes in tangible values, changes in book value, earnings, changes in earnings, dividends, and all that gives you also an academic background, an academic safety when it comes to investing. So again, low risk and high potential returns. Before that, I started investing in 2002, always following Buffett, trying to find good investments when the market was offering them, patiently waiting for them, and I did pretty well for myself. I have high double-digit returns, above 15% over the last 17 years, with some great investments that I was fortunate to find, and I'm continuing to do the same. Margin of safety, good business returns. It has worked in the past. I don't see why it will not work in the future as it did in the past. And also on my portfolios that I manage now, it works again as it did in the past. So I keep doing what I am doing, even if it is boring, intrinsic value, analysis, focusing on risk. I'm not a YouTuber, so don't expect that on my channel. I will not do a video as soon as Elon Musk farts or something, do a video about it. There is plenty of YouTube channels that do that. So if you want analysis, if you want value investing mindset, really focused on risk, limiting risk, but increasing returns, avoiding the exuberant, the hot stocks, and focusing simply on, okay, this is common sense investing, then this is the channel for you, with a little bit of education from an accounting perspective, from my accounting background, with a little bit of education from an investing mindset background, which is so important. We have to be greedy when others are fearful, and fearful when others are greedy. It is actually so simple, and that's the message I want to transmit to the audience. So, is this channel for you? Check a few videos, see what we do. I will try to incorporate an educational part because not every stock is, oh, buy this, buy that. If you want those that buy everything constantly, then again, there are plenty of other YouTube channels there. If you want to know more about what I do, there is my website, www.svencarlin.com, and also in the link in the description of this video, you can find more about my stock market research, my portfolios. Everything that I do is there. You can see my portfolios, what I own, every trade. I send an email every time that I do a trade. So if you're interested in something like that, if you want to know more about it, please check the links in the description below or send me an email. Let me know if you have more questions. I'm always happy to hear about what investors are saying, your worries, because that's why we are here, to help you reach low risk, high returns over the very, very long term. For that, you need a value investing mindset, do not do stupid things, apply common sense, and look at business returns, not at what the stock can do or might do in the next 6 months. Thank you for watching, looking forward to your comments. Let me know if there is anything I have to explain, and I'll see you in the next video.